Good morning to you. My name is Mike Lawton, and it's a privilege to bring you a reflection from Christchurch Chorleywood. November has been a time of remembrance. November the 11th, 1918, we remembered Armistice Day, the time when the war, First World War, ended. But on November the 11th, we not only celebrate or give thanks for Armistice Day, but we also remember World War II, the end of that war, which ended in May 1945, and subsequent wars that happened. People gave their lives, particularly in World War I and World War II, that we can have the life that we have now, because being world wars, the whole world was really involved. Now, many, many gave their lives. And there's some very poignant statements about this, lest we forget. Another one which is really applicable is all gave some, but some gave all. And everybody in those world wars was doing something. They struggled, but they gave. Whether they were at home, the women were working in the factories to produce weapons and other means of helping in the war effort, working on the land, providing food. The men, of course, fighting. And when I saw that statement, all gave some, but some gave all, I thought then of another time of remembrance in December, when we remember Jesus Christ, his birth. Now, he gave us all, he gave his life, us. And to put it into context, in the beginning, God created the world. His creation covered 6 days, and after he created the earth and all that's in it and the animals, he created man, you and I. And that was the apple of his eye. That's what he had really, really done creation for, because they were the last to be created and they lived in the Garden of Eden. And in the evening, Adam always used to communicate with God. They met together. In fact, they had a position which was unique. However, they were given free choice. They could choose to worship God, or they could choose to go their own way. And Satan tempted them, and they chose to go their own way, and they lost that fellowship with God the Father. And they had to work the land, and their life was just one of seeing life through day to day. Now God pined for them, and he raised up a people, the Jews, and gave them laws so that if they followed these laws, they could find a relationship with God again. Because they also gave, God also gave a way for them to sacrifice and have their sins covered so that they may have a relationship with God the Father. It wasn't quite the same as now, but it was a way of them being blessed by God. And if they followed the law and did what was right, then God blessed them, particularly if the kings did this. Now, some were good kings, some were bad. Unfortunately, man being man, it was not possible for them to fulfill the law, and they struggled. Now, that's the context in which Jesus comes, because Jesus was the Son of God. And he, the Christ, He knew that the creation of God, man, the apple of God's eye, were lost to God. And he saw that man just could not fulfill the law and come back to God. So he opted to come down from heaven, and he was born in this earth of the Virgin Mary. And he grew up and he fulfilled the law in all its niceties, and he was sinless. He was the only one who could do it, and he did it. Now, he gave his life for you and I. He didn't have to. He knew that we were subject to death, but he died on our behalf. He took away all the wrongdoing within us. He fulfilled that law. And because of his blood, anybody who came to Jesus would come to the Father. And indeed, it said in Galatians, and it was the Galatians chapter 3, that in coming to the Lord, he was making us all sons of God through faith in Jesus Christ. Not only that, but through his death and resurrection, the Holy Spirit could come. And the Holy Spirit came upon those who had followed him, his disciples, at Pentecost. And the church was formed, the church that you and I attend today. That was where it came from. And the Holy Spirit is the key to the work of the church, work for you and I. And so we remember at this time the birth of Jesus Christ. And we can celebrate that with our families, and we give presents. And it's a time of just being generous to all, albeit God wants us to be generous all the time. We give thanks, God. And you and I should never forget that without Him, we could not have this relationship with God. And we should treasure it, we should nurture it, and we should really seek it out all the time. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And he said, all these things were added unto you. Now, in seeking first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, we can receive that in Jesus Christ. I'll leave that with you, and may this time be a blessed time when you remember the birth of Jesus. Shall we pray? Dear Lord and Father, thank you for Jesus. Thank you that he has made it possible for each one of us to have this relationship with you, because you have restored us to being sons of yours through Jesus Christ. And thank you, this is an ongoing thing, not only for us, but our children and our children's children. And it is through Jesus Christ that you have done this. So help us, Lord, to fulfill the faith that we need and to follow Jesus. And the song I leave with you is something, a carol that we sing called In the Bleak Midwinter, because it speaks of a time when Jesus was born, but it came to the time when the verse says, what can I give him, poor as I am? If I was a shepherd, I'd give a lamb. If I was a wise man, I would play my part. I've done nothing, so what can I give him? Give I God bless you.